Hello friends, this is my second video on financial market, and in this video I would like to explain the major concepts and theories of capital market. In the last video class we studied the financial market is built up with two components like money market and capital market. So capital market is an important element of financial market. So what is capital market? It's a market for medium and long-term securities where debt and equities are traded. That means debentures, and equity means equity shares. See, again, the capital market is divided into two segments, or capital market has two segments. One is primary market and second one is secondary market. So primary market is a market for new shares, means primary market is a market where equities and debentures are firstly offered into the market. Therefore, it is also known as new issue market, means NIM. The secondary market is a market for existing securities where continuous buying and selling of existing securities takes place in the secondary market. Clear? So it is also known as stock market or stock exchange. Let's see the first segment, new issue market or primary market. Suppose, imagine you are the CFO of a particular company, chief financial officer of a particular company, and your company wish to issue new shares or debentures. So what are the alternative you can choose for the fresh issue of shares and debentures? These are the five methods that we can adopt for the issue of new shares. So the first one, it is issued through prospectus. Prospectus are the invitation to public for subscribing shares and debentures. So by issuing prospectus, the company can raise capital. The second alternative, it is offer for sale. It is an indirect IPO. Under this method, the issuing company sells its entire securities to an intermediary, and the intermediary sells to public at a higher price.
Clear.
The third is private placement. In private placement, securities are offered to selected individuals or institutions. And fourth one, it is right issue. As per Section 81 of Companies Act, when a company makes further issue of shares, it should be firstly offered to existing shareholders, and it is their right. Such shares are called right shares. And the fifth one, the final one, it is EIPO. This is the latest method generally used by most of the companies. And here, it is issuing securities through the online system of stock exchanges. So these are the five methods of issuing new shares into the market.
Now, just before secondary market or stock market, let's have a comparison between primary market and secondary market. Firstly, primary market deals with new securities. However, secondary market deals with existing securities. The second thing, securities are sold once. In primary market, all securities are sold once. But here, it provides regular and continuous market. Then third point, it is a point from the side of investors' point of view. Investors can only purchase securities from the primary market. But here, investors can purchase and sell securities in the secondary market. The next point, it provides capital to the company. But here, issuing company has no direct role in the secondary market. And finally, it has no physical existence. Primary market has no physical existence. But here, it has physical existence in the form of stock exchange. Okay. So we studied the secondary market. Secondary market is a market for existing securities, and secondary market is concerned with the stock exchange. So what is stock exchange? A stock exchange is an institution which provides a platform for buying and selling of existing securities. Clear? So that's an important question. Stock exchange is considered as the economic barometer. Now, what are the functions of a stock exchange? Stock exchange, the first function, it is providing liquidity and marketability to existing securities. Because in the definition itself, it says stock exchange provides a platform for buying and selling of existing securities. The second thing it says, pricing of securities. Securities are priced in stock exchange based on market force like demand and supply. The third function, it is a safety of transaction. Stock exchanges have to ensure safety of transactions, and they have to protect the interest of investors. The next one, contribute to economic growth. Stock exchanges plays an important role in the economic development of the country. Then act as an economic barometer. Then next function, it is spreading equity culture or investment culture. The next one, it is providing a scope for speculation. For ensuring an efficient and active market, stock exchanges provide a platform for speculative trade and speculative transaction. So these are the important functions of a stock exchange. Okay. See some important points from this area, means secondary market. One is Bombay Stock Exchange. BSE means Bombay Stock Exchange. It is the first stock exchange in Asia, and it was established in the year 1875. And its index is called Sensex, and it consists of 30 shares. Next, it is NSE, National Stock Exchange. It was established in the year 1992 and recognized in the year 1993. And its index is called Nifty, and Nifty consisting 50 shares. Next, it is OTCI, Over-the-Counter Exchange of India, is an arrangement for small and medium companies who couldn't fulfill the listing procedure in BSE and NSE. Next, it is T+2. T+2 means trade plus 2 trade days. It is a settlement cycle in the Indian stock market. Means settlements are takes place after 2 trade days. The last topic in this chapter is SEBI. It's very important for examination. SEBI means Securities and Exchange Board of India. It was established in the year 1988 and recognized as a statutory body in the 1992. Objectives of SEBI: to regulate the stock exchange and securities market, then to protect rights and interests of investors and guide and educate them, to prevent trade malpractices. Then next, it is to regulate and develop a code of conduct. Now, functions of SEBI. SEBI's functions can be presented under three heads: regulatory functions, developmental functions, and protective functions. Under regulatory functions, SEBI undertakes registration of brokers and sub-brokers, registration of collective investment schemes like mutual funds, regulation of takeover bids, and inspection of stock exchange. Then SEBI also undertaking some development functions like training of intermediaries, conducting researches and publishing the papers, then investors education, undertaking measures to develop capital markets. And finally, it is protective functions. The protective functions involves prohibit unfair trade practices, prohibit insider trading, then undertaking steps for investors protection, then promotion of fair practices. So that is the end of the chapter, and keep learning. Thank you.